Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video yield function in Excel, watch the video till the end, and if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone. Let's understand this function in Excel, how exactly yield function. We have all studied yield in our books, in probably in our MBA program, or probably in our CA or a CFA program. But what does, or how exactly the implementation part comes when we see the Excel or the real life into picture? Well, let's begin. On the first and the foremost note, I want you to understand first that, see, yield function is basically, it's a very sort of, you can say, the advanced function that is used to calculate the amount of the income that is generated each year from the investment amount. So generally, yield function is an Excel that is used to calculate the yield on bonds to determine income that would be generated each year on a security amount that provides periodical investment. Now, the yield formula in Excel, how exactly it's calculated. Okay, if you start with yield over here, just write YIELD. As you can see, just once I've written YI, it shows me the formula. It says that returns the yield on the security that pays the periodical interest. Well, if I press tab button, they have so many other things. We'll start with the explanation. See, there are 7 parameters that are used in, as you can see, there are so many parameters that are there to calculate the bond yield in Excel, in which, you know, 6 parameters are completely compulsory. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This basis is optional. We'll understand each of them. Now, first, the settlement part. See the date. This is basically the date on which the coupon is purchased by the buyer, or the date on which the bond is purchased, or the settlement date of the security. Now, the maturity part. Now, maturity date of the security, or the date, it is the date on which the purchased coupon expires. The rate is the annual coupon rate of the security. PR represents the security price per 100 stated value. Then comes the redemption. Now, redemption is the redemption value of the security per $100 stated value. Frequency means the number of the coupons that is paid in a year. It can be 1 for annual payment, 2 for semi-annual, and 4 for quarterly payment. Now, the basis. The optional parameter over here is always appearing in brackets, as you can see in an Excel yield formula. Here the basis is optional argument, so it comes as basis. So basis is basically optional integer parameter which specifies the day count basis that is used by security, and the possible values for basis are 0, you know, that is US 30 to 360, 1 actual, 2 actual 360, 3 actual 365, and European is 30 and 360. Now, how to use this yield function in Excel? See, yield in an Excel can be used in a worksheet function, like normal yield formulas that is used in Excel. Now, let's understand this working on bond yield function in Excel with few examples. See, bond yield calculation Excel for quarterly payment. Let's consider the settlement date as 17th of May 2018, and the maturity date is 17 May 2020 for the purchase coupon. So the rate of interest over here is 5%. The rate of interest over here is 5%, and the price is 101. The redemption over here is value is 100, and the payment terms of the frequency is quarterly. So what will be our yield? Well, we'll start with is equal to yield. First is the settlement. So settlement will be settlement date. Then is the maturity date, that is C4, the rate of interest, that is 5%, then is the PR, right? PR is the price per 100 FV, then is our redemption, redemption value is 100, and because it is quarterly, so we'll say quarterly. The frequency. So once we have written C74, just write frequency 0. We'll go with the US one. So it says 4.475. Now, let's take another example for semi-annually. We'll say yield, the settlement date, the maturity date, the rate of interest, the price, the redemption value, and 2 here, that is semi-annual, comma. Over here, again, we'll take 0 for US, that is 4.472. Now, the bond yield in Excel for yearly payment is different. Let's consider the settlement date over here as 17th of May 2018 and the maturity day as 17th of May 2020. The rate of interest, price and redemption value is, let's say, 5%, 101, 100 and yearly. So, for semi-yearly, the payment frequency will be 1. The output yield will be 4.46. Now, how exactly that will work? So, is equal to yield, settlement, maturity, rate of interest, price, redemption value. The frequency is going to be annual, 0, close the bracket, that is 4.466. Well, this was the example that you need to understand. Now, I want you to understand some of the things to remember about the yield function. Now, there are some error details which can come across in the bond yield function due to the type mismatch. The first one is called the num error, and there may be two possibilities for this error in the bond yield in Excel. First, if the settlement date in the yield function in Excel, I'm just writing SD, settlement date in the yield function is greater than the or equal to the maturity date, then num error occurs. Second, invalid numbers are given to rate, PR, and redemption frequency or basis parameter. Now, if rate is less than 0, then the yield in Excel returns the num error. If the PR is less than or equal to 0 and redemption is also less than or equal to 0, then the yield Excel function returns to the num error. Now, if the given frequency is not, let's say, 1, 2, and 4, then the yield Excel function returns to the num error. Now, if that is less than 0, or if the basis is greater than 4, then the yield Excel function returns to the num error, right? So, if any given parameters are non-numbers or the data are not provided in the date format, it will show us a value error, right? Like Microsoft Excel stores the data sequence from 1st January 1900 as number 1 and some numbers days as, you know, 17 January over here. So, if you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.